Hello friends, today we will see 3D transformation. So I have written over here 3D translation, then we will see 3D rotation and then 3D scaling. So let's get started with 3D translation. So 3D translation requires three translation values, okay, respectively x, then translation value with respect to y and translation value with respect to z. So let's take an example. I want to translate this point P, which is in a three dimensional space, that is x comma y comma z, to a new coordinate or to a new location, which is given by P dash. The new location, the new coordinates are x dash, y dash, z dash. Okay, now if I have to do that, I will write this particular matrix representation which we are carrying from a two dimensional transformations. So I will have object matrix onto the extreme right hand, and then whatever transformation that I want to apply will be pre-multiplied to the object matrix, and that is going to give me, the multiplication is going to give me the new transformed coordinates of this object. Okay, new transformed coordinates of this object. Now since it is a homogeneous coordinate system, okay, so as we added a row and column, okay, in the two dimensional transformations for homogeneous coordinates, so in two dimensional transformations our matrix order was 3 by 3. Now similarly in three dimensional transformations our matrix order is always going to be 4 by 4 for all the transformation matrices. Okay, so just continuing further from two-dimensional translation, we only had tx, ty as the translation coordinates in terms of x and y respectively, or translation values in terms of, or translation vector in terms of x and y respectively. Okay, now we will also have an additional translation vector in terms of z, and that will be arranged in a transformation matrix in this particular manner. So it will have 1, 0, 0, tx, 0, 1, 0, ty, 0, 0, 1, tz, and the last row is going to be 0, 0, 0, 1. So when we apply, when we multiply with this transformation matrix, the object matrix, okay, of this point P, the answer is going to be the new transformed coordinates for point P, which is given by P dash. So in other words, this point P will be translated from this current location XY to this new location X dash Y dash Z dash, okay, in this manner. So this is a three-dimensional translation. Okay, three-dimensional translation. So all x-axis, y-axis, z-axis translation vectors are applied. Okay, translation vectors are applied. Then we'll see 3D rotation. So when we want to see 3D rotation, then there are three cases that will arise, because rotation is a planar phenomena. It requires a perpendicular axis, okay, and a plane. So the object would definitely be in plane. Okay, as far as two dimensional rotation is concerned, we have already seen the plane is xy plane, and the rotation axis by default is a perpendicular axis coming out of that xy plane, which is z, and that is why in two dimensional transformations or two dimensional rotations there was only one possibility, that rotation about z. That was the default case. Okay, now when we come in three dimensional, okay, we can have rotations with respect to three axes separately, because all the three axes are coming from their respective normal planes. Okay, are coming out or are normal to their respective planes. Okay, so xy plane, the normal axis is z axis. Okay, for yz plane, the normal axis is x axis, and then xz plane, the normal axis is y axis. So we can have rotations about all these three axes. So we'll start with the known condition which we have carried from two dimensional rotation, that is rotation about z axis. Okay, so this we have seen during the two dimensional rotation. This equation we derived, okay, x dash is equal to x cos theta minus y sin theta, and y dash is x sin theta plus y cos theta. Okay, since we have rotation about z axis, so the z dash is going to remain unchanged. Okay, z dash is going to remain unchanged. So z dash is equal to z. So when we try to combine all these equations into matrix form, what we get? We get this rotation about Z matrix, that is cos theta minus sin theta 0 0, sin theta cos theta 0 0, 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 0 1. So if you just concentrate on this 3 by 3 matrix order, okay, it is exactly same as 2D rotation matrix, okay, 2D rotation matrix, and we have an added row and column because of the homogeneous coordinates, okay, because of the homogeneous coordinates. So even though we are compiling the 3D rotations, okay, but in a way you can say that it's a 2D kind of a phenomena, okay, with an additional axis which remains unchanged because about that axis the rotation is happening. Okay, so as you can see, x, y are changing, z is remaining unchanged because rotation is happening about z, and the same concept will continue when we will find out the rotation about x axis. Okay, rotation about x axis, as you can see over here, see the sequence, okay, sequence of finding the successive rotations about the next and next axis is being followed from this order. So x, y, z, x, okay, x, y, z, x. So far what we have done, we have found rotation about z, okay, then we will find rotation about x, and then we will again find rotation about y. So it is like a continuous thing. So after x there will be y, okay, and again there will be z, and this will continue endless. So it's like a cycle, okay. So it is x, you can represent it like this also, this is y, this is z, okay. So that would be the ideal representation. So after, once the z rotation is done, then there will be x rotation, then there will be y rotation. So that is going to be the sequence, okay, that is going to be the sequence. So that is why we are taking x rotation, that is a rotation about x axis, the second condition, okay. Now since rotation about x axis, now what we have discovered in this, okay, rotation about z, okay, what happens? Z remains unchanged. So that is what going to happen with rotation about x axis as well. So x will remain unchanged, so x dash is going to be x. Then in sequence yz, okay, in sequence yz is going to be what? Y will be given, y dash will be given by y cos theta minus z sin theta, and z dash will be given as y sin theta plus z cos theta. Now what I am doing over here, okay, cos theta minus sin theta cos theta, they remain at their position, okay. Here I had xy, so I wrote here xy, xy. Here I have yz, so I will wrote here yz, yz, okay. So this sequence will also continue, okay, this sequence will also continue. And what is happening over here, the rotation is happening about y axis. So you can say if the object is somewhere here, okay, object is somewhere here, okay, what will happen? It will be rotated and the object will come somewhere here, okay. It may be in yz plane only, since it's a three dimensional transformation, it would be a 3D object as well, okay, it would be a 3D object as well. How we will come to know rotation is happening about x, okay, when we will actually solve the problems, we will see x coordinates are not changing, okay, x coordinates are not changing. The height with respect which is measured in terms of the rotation axis, okay, that height is unchanged because the rotation is happening about that axis, okay. So that is the clue to find out whether the answers are correct or not, okay. So that is the reason why y dash is y cos theta minus z sin theta, and z dash is given by y sin theta plus z cos theta. When I try to arrange this in the matrix order, remember we are only going to follow, even though I have written these equations in this manner, okay, I will always prefer writing them in let's say, I will prefer writing x dash up here, okay, writing x dash up here. So that is why x value, that is the 1 comma 1 value, will remain 1. So I will have first row as 1 0 0 0, then I will have all the columns in the first, or the all the first, the elements in the first column, okay, will be 0 because I have to leave now first row and first column. Okay, now I will be starting from the second row, that is cos theta minus sin theta cos theta, that is cos theta minus sin theta cos theta, and then I will have my last row as 0001, last column also as 0001. Okay, so this is rotation about x, and then third there will be rotation about y. So this is my y axis, rotation will carry about this axis. So let's say any object which is, let's say, lying over here, okay, will eventually be rotated and will be brought somewhere over here. Okay, if it's a 3D object, okay, never mind, 3D object will also be rotated in similar manner. What I said, since it is rotation about y axis, so all the y coordinates will remain unchanged. Okay, will remain unchanged, their values will be same even after rotation. Okay, even after rotation. Now what is happening over here? Okay, remember this chain. So we first had rotation about z. Okay, we first had rotation about z. So we wrote equations in x and y, and z remain unchanged. Then we had rotation about x, so we wrote equations in yz. Okay, we wrote equations in yz and x remain unchanged. And then we have rotation about x, rotation about y. Okay, rotation about y. So we will be writing equations in z followed by x. Okay, that is going to be the sequence in order to generate the equation. So z axis will come first. So z axis is what? Then I have z dash as z cos theta minus x sin theta, and x dash as z sin theta plus x cos theta. Okay, plus x cos theta, and y will be remaining unchanged. That is y dash is equal to y. So first let me put the value for my y axis. So y dash equal to y, that is my 2, 2 position will have value 1 because that is unchanged, and the corresponding row and the column, that is second row and second column, will have all the remaining elements as 0, 0. Okay, all the remaining elements as 0, 0. So as you can see over here, this is having value 1, and the remaining elements in that row and second column, all are zeros. Okay, then I will be, see, I would want to rewrite this. Okay, I would want to rewrite this over here. Okay, since I want to represent this inside a matrix, so what I can do is I will just rewrite this keeping x in front, minus x sin theta plus z cos theta, and here x cos theta plus z sin theta. So that is going to be the real sequence. Okay, that is going to be the real sequence. So, and the sequence that I will be always following is going to be this sequence only, x dash, y dash, and z dash. Okay, so x dash is going to be equal to always x cos theta plus z sin theta. Then y dash is equal to y, and z dash is equal to minus x sin theta plus z cos theta. So now when I try to represent this in the matrix, so what happens is this is going to be my first row, and this is going to be first column, and this is going to be my third column. Similarly, row wise, this is going to be first row and this is going to be third row. Okay, and this y is by default coming at 2, 2 position. Okay, 2, 2 position in my matrix. So this 2, 2 position gets occupied over here. It gets occupied over here. Okay, and then as you can see, x cos theta. So cos theta comes over here, 0, then sin theta comes over here, then 0, then 0, 1, 0, 0 is the second row, and then for z dash I have minus sin theta coming over here, 0, then cos theta coming over here, 0, and then I have the last row, 0, 0, 0, 1. So that is the only minor change that we need to keep in mind, that sin theta is not negative over here, but it is negative over here. Okay, that is the only change that you need to remember while you are writing a transformation matrix for rotation about y axis. Okay, I hope this point is clear. okay, and the last transformation that we are going to look is three-dimensional scaling. Okay, three-dimensional scaling. So three-dimensional scaling is very straightforward. Okay, you require three scaling factors, typically with respect to x, that is sx, with respect to y, that is sy, and with respect to z, that is sz. Okay, and the scaling transformation matrix, that is 3D scaling transformation matrix, is given by sx 0 0 0 0 sy 0 0 0 0 sz 0 0 0 0 1, where sx, sy and sz scaling factors okay with respect to x, y and z axis. Okay, if all these scaling factors are same, then the object will be uniformly scaled, okay, into the three-dimensional reference frame. If these scaling factors are different, then it is going to be a non-uniform three-dimensional scaling. Okay, again, the scaling by default will be carried out about origin, okay, with respect to origin. So if I have scaling factors which are greater than 1, then the object will tend to move away from the origin, and if I have scaling factors less than 1, then the object will tend to move towards the origin. Okay, apart from that, all the other operations are exactly same. So I hope you have understood the basic three-dimensional transformations. Okay, hope to see you next time with some problems, okay, on three-dimensional transformations. Thank you.